Global warming is one of the most important issues facing us today. Scientists have shown that starting with the Industrial Revolution, our increase of fossil fuels is increasing the warmth of planet Earth. Humans are now pushing Mother Nature like never before. Global warming and climate change have the potential to alter biological systems, such as weather patterns, wildlife, and the glaciers and sea levels. Less than 3% of Earth's water is fresh water. And most of that 3% is inaccessible, because over 68% of the fresh water on Earth is trapped in ice caps and glaciers. But due to global warming, glaciers and ice caps are rapidly melting, and mass amounts of fresh water are lost into the ocean's salt water.
The Patagonian ice field is the largest expanse of ice outside of Antarctica and Greenland. It encompasses almost 7,000 square miles and extends all the way to the Pacific Ocean. In 1998, the expanse of water was completely filled with icebergs. Now, almost all the ice has melted, and this has caused immense flooding in the area. In the last 7 years, many of the glaciers that were once a half mile thick have lost 10% of their mass. In Montana, glaciers that are thousands of years old are melting so rapidly that they will completely disappear within 30 years. Over 150 glaciers once occupied the region, yet today there are less than 40. Glaciers that formed over thousands of years are disappearing within decades. Land masses of ice that once spanned from the Andes to Alaska are diminishing at an alarming rate. Another example would be the Larsen B ice sheet. Occupying 11,500 square kilometers at its largest, Larsen B was the greatest ice sheet. It collapsed in 2002 due to a series of consecutive abnormally warm summers and caused extreme flooding in the Antarctic. Together, Larsen A and B were losing between 22 and 40 gigatons of their mass a year in 2006.
The consequences of this are devastating. In the last 100 years, the sea level has risen about 8 inches. Antarctica is covered in about 2,100 meters of ice. If this were to all melt, the oceans would rise about 200 feet. By the year 2100, oceans will have risen 1 meter, which will have damaging effects on the cities near the oceans. Low-lying regions such as Florida, Vietnam, and Bangladesh will be devastated. All the vital rice crops in Vietnam would also be lost. The 100 million people who live within 3 feet of sea level will be forced to move elsewhere. Cities will also be forced to spend trillions on building up coastal defenses. These could be the flooded cities of the future.
The Himalayas are the highest mountains on Earth and is one of the planet's greatest freshwater reserves. This water comes from glaciers and snow. However, global warming has caused these glaciers to melt. Asia will be the hardest hit region from this catastrophe. The Himalayas span across 8 Asian countries and supply water to approximately 1.5 billion people. As the glaciers melt, there will be less fresh water accessible to this population. In addition, excess water on the mountains will drain into local towns and destroy their homes as well.
Thousand-year-old African mountain peaks, once covered in ice, are expected to be gone in the next 20 years. The changes in air temperatures that are causing the glaciers to melt, mainly in the Rwenzori Mountains and in Kilimanjaro, are allowing mosquitoes to live there and are now spreading even more disease, such as malaria. The melting of ice also poses a big threat to the native wildlife. Many species of endangered animals live there, like elephants, chimpanzees, and the estimate of 89 different bird species. Polar bears have evolved to survive the sea ice during the harsh winters of the Arctic climate. They rely heavily on the combination of both geology and climate to survive. The bears hunt seals on the ice during the winter. In summer, when the ice melts, the bears come ashore. But due to rapidly diminishing ice, even in the winter, the polar bears are left stranded on the land, unable to hunt for food during the winter. Sea ice loss also causes lower cub survival rates, increase in drowning, increase in cannibalism, loss of access to denning areas, and a rapidly declining population size. Glaciers, and the rising of the oceans is a big problem. It's just one of the ways that global warming is negatively affecting our environment. Its effects are not only damaging to just about every nation on Earth, but also the Earth's wildlife. The melting of glaciers and ice caps is a major warning sign of what can occur with global warming, and it affects every aspect of life.
Many people realize that global warming and climate change is bad for the environment. We need to reduce our ecological footprint, and to do so, we can recycle, carpool, bus, cycle, walk, not burn fossil fuels, and more.